Welcome everyone, and it is Friday, and today we're going to be checking out BIOSes for CPU mining and how to set them up for HiveOS and Linux-based operating systems, as well as you can do it in Windows as well if you like to overclock that way. But we're going to be looking at our MSI X470 Gaming Max motherboard and an ASUS Tough Gaming X570 motherboard. I do have my monitor and everything set up right there, so let's get into it. All right, guys, welcome, Rabid here. Today we are going to be looking at the motherboard BIOSes in the X470 and the X570 MSI ASUS and see what the difference is and what you actually have to do. Now, I did do that HiveOS video where we used my workstation, which was a gigabyte, but people seem to be having issues with the X470 MSI motherboard, can't get their settings in. So that is why I am here today. I'm going to be showing you how to do your settings in that X470 MSI motherboard. And as well, seeing how we're here, we're going to do this ASUS X570 as well. Now, we're going to look at the two brands. Each manufacturer does have their BIOS a little bit different. Again, we've seen the Gigabyte one in that last video, but I will put a clip to that one in the end of this one, so all three motherboards are here. Here we are. First up is our ASUS BIOS here, and most of the ASUS boards, they're all the same depending on the version number. Now, whether you update, get an older one, whatever, it could be a little different, but for the most part, everything is called and named the same across the ASUS BIOSes. So first thing we are gonna have to do, we have to go to Advanced Options. That's F7. Here we are in F7. We're gonna go over to Advanced. Now, if you're doing a first fresh setup, you are gonna have to go down here. We're already on it. APM configuration. And this is where we actually set our motherboard to power on an AC power loss. So restore AC power loss, mine is still on. Default, it is off, so you will have to go into here and turn that on. Now, what this does do is when you lose power to your house or you turn your power supply off or something and you turn it back on or regain power, it will automatically reboot your rig. So again, just like your GPU mining rigs, you always want to turn this option on first thing. Next on our list, we are going to set the clocks to our CPU. So we're going to go over to from main to AI tweaker. You just hit the right button. My PSU just ramped up, so I'm not sure how bad you guys can hear that. So we're gonna go down here. Here you can see CPU core ratio per CCX. We're gonna click on that, and this is where we manually set it. So again, 36 means 3.6 gigahertz. Now shift plus will make it go up, and just minus will make it go down. So here we are, we're already set up across them all. This is where you set your overclocks. You're gonna do it per CCX and make sure it is all set at 3.6. Again, you can set it whatever you want. It's all up to you depending on power. I find these to be nice, efficient settings and what I do run all my 3900X CPUs at. Next up, we're gonna have to set that core voltage. So we're gonna scroll down here until we find the voltage right here. It's gonna be auto by default. You just go down, click on manual, scroll down, and again, shift plus makes it go up and the minus makes it go down. I run everything at 1 volt. You can get away on some of them, most of them actually, silicon lottery 0.95, but I said one rig did have issues, so I just put them all at 1 volt. Maybe I'll go through and fine tune everything. They might all run at 0.75 or something, so or 0.97, but we'll see. Right now everything is 1 volt. Now we're gonna have to go into overclock our RAM. Now what I mean by overclock profiles, that's your XMP profiles, or depending on manufacturers, DCOMP. So we're gonna come down here. I saw DRAM here somewhere. Whereabouts was it? Overclock DRAM right here. So memory frequency. Now here, it does not list it as XMP or anything. You actually set it to what you want it to run at. So this is 3200 megahertz RAM. If I wanted to run it at 3200, I would just scroll down to right there. And now this, I'd hit enter, and that's 3200 megahertz. Again, I am not overclocking it. This is the same as running XMP 3200 megahertz. So when you buy RAM, you know it says 3200 megahertz RAM. By default, it is not set to that. You manually have to add that in your BIOS. But I do find that running the RAM at its full speed does reduce the efficiency and doesn't maximize your hash rates too much. So I'm just gonna escape out of there, because I am running this default 2133 megahertz and not running the actual XMP profile or DOCP depending on the manufacturer. Now some people, depending on your experience level, they like to change their SOC voltage here as well. I usually leave mine on auto and don't really touch it. What the SOC voltage actually does do is think of your motherboard and your CPU as the body and the heart. So your CPU is the heart. Your SoC voltage is actually the voltage that goes to all your peripherals, your I/O and everything. So you can adjust the voltage. It's almost like adjusting your blood pressure. Do you want more voltage or less? Higher blood pressure or less blood pressure? That's kind of how the SoC voltage does come into play. So I leave mine at auto. I don't usually touch it because we're not really using any AIO. So technically you could reduce that. But again, I'm not going to touch it. Here we are in our MSI BIOS. This is the X470 Gaming Plus Max motherboard to be perfect. So you may, depending where you end up, you could be in this one, which is easy mode. Just hit F7, just like our ASUS. And this is the advanced mode. It could boot up either one. Now you do have your settings, OC and M flash under your advanced tab here. M flash, that is to use a USB drive, flash your BIOS to a newer version, or go back down to an older version. Now, different BIOS versions have been noticeably more stable. Other times, also others can give you more hash rate. So it's good to test around with all the BIOSes of your motherboard. At the same time, if you don't know what you're doing, it's not really recommended to flash your BIOS unless you absolutely have to. So we're gonna go into settings here in our advanced menu. Scroll down here again, advanced. And now we're gonna go to power management setup. This is where you set your AC power off or on deal. So restore after AC power loss. Mine is on, this is where you would go. Default is off, so you turn that on. And again, what that does is so you do not need the power button. And if you shut your power supply off or you lose power or something, it will automatically turn back on once you do turn it on or your power comes back. Now that we have this thing ready to fire back up, anytime we do turn the power switch off or on by itself without a switch, we gotta do our overclock. So that's quite simple, you scroll down. Here you'll go to your OC method. And now you can see everything we have right here. So we're gonna start right here. You can see AXMP, this is your RAM detail. So it is disabled. This does have XMP in it, unlike the ASUS where you set it directly depending on the speed that you want. So XMP profile 1 or 2, I am disabled. XMP profile off. Now if I went profile 1 or 2, you can see the RAM settings here. I went 1, that will set it now to 3200 megahertz. And down here you can see they're both pretty much set the same. Now deep inside, some RAM does have 2 or 3 profiles, and the higher the number, the little tighter the timings are, and it's supposed to be more faster, but at the same time, it could become less stable. So we're gonna go back to disable because I do not use that. Again, we find it more efficient not running any XMP profile. So now we're gonna have to overclock our CPU here. Default mode, I believe this is usually set to all core. I always go per CCX, just so I know. You can go all core, and again, 3600, shift plus, brings it up and minus brings it down. So there we are, 3600, that is 3.6 gigahertz all core. Do that across all four CCXs that you see here, your ratios. And then we're gonna have to set our core voltage. Scroll down till we do find our voltage settings. Here we are, CPU core voltage, AMD overclocking. Now again, this is usually set on auto. I click on that, go down to AMD overclocking, which you can see there. Go down and here's your voltage. You'll see one under the override CPU core voltage. Shift plus again, puts it up, and minus brings it down. All done, you are now totally set. This is how you overclock your CPU and your RAM in your BIOS for say HiveOS and Linux based operating systems. And some people prefer this way as it's more stable over Ryzen Master, even for Windows systems. Again, everyone does their own thing, so do what you do feel safe with. Now we're gonna look for our CPU SoC voltage. Where are you hiding here? You're down here somewhere. Just like before, that is the blood system for your actual CPU. So it was hiding right underneath our CPU core voltage. So just click down a couple and you will find CPU MB SoC voltages. So this is where you would set that SoC. And as you can see, it is slightly different than what our ASUS was putting out, but it doesn't matter. I do not set that, I just leave it auto. Again, you can do as you please on your own motherboards. Once you are done, depending any motherboard actually, I believe F10 for the ASUS and this X11 is safe, so you can go right there. Now you do not have to change anything to actually get a GPU not to boot on this. So you can pull your GPU off this said motherboard. Again, I have not tested my ASUS to see if it does do that. So keep in mind, depending on your motherboard, you may not be able to run it headless with non-integrated graphics. This is a Gigabyte motherboard. Now, depending on the manufacturer of your motherboard, everything could be different. Example, XMP profile is called XMP. That's your RAM settings in your motherboard for overclocking, running it at 3200 megahertz or the stock settings. When I do refer to that, that is XMP. Now, depending on your motherboard, like some do call XMP DOCP in your motherboard. Others, like ASUS, they actually just have the straight megahertz. You have to set the actual megahertz what you want it to be. So things are a little different. As well, most require F7 take you advanced mode. This one does is actually F2. So here you can see, here is actually right now XMP extreme memory profile XMP. It is disabled. This I find to be the most efficient settings instead of running XMP. So if I hit that and I go profile one, that will actually engage it and tell it to run. Right here you can see 32, so 3200 megahertz, but that is less efficient. I like to run mine disabled off, and here you can see it's going to run 2133 megahertz, which we're already doing over here is the 2141.86, I guess it's saying. So I find that most efficient. When I say XMP profile off, that means disabled in here. We are not running our RAM at the exact full speed that it does say to use. Now we're going to set our actual gigahertz on our CPU. So here you can see CPU clock ratio. Again, each motherboard will label it something different depending on the brand, but these are the main things you do got to look for. So CPU clock ratio, I'm going auto. This is set on all core already. You can see per CCX, which means per cluster of cores, which you do see in Ryzen Master. Each CCX are their clusters there. But here we're just going to go all core. We're going to scroll all the way down until we do hit 3.6 or 36.00 in the case of this motherboard. I passed it already. So scroll up. Come on, we're almost there. Right there. So there we are. 36. So that's all core. Now we're not done yet. We do have to actually set our voltage. So here we're going to scroll down, CPU V-core. That is our voltage of our CPU. Again, I run everything at 1 volt. So I'm just going to scroll down to the 1 volt or just click on it right there. Done. And now you just hit F10, which is save all your settings, and you're good to go for Hive OS. That is how you do your BIOS settings. And then this time, once your motherboard, your system, whatever, if you reboot it, restart it, whatever, these are the settings it will load, and that way it is running in Hive OS 100%. All right guys, so that does sum up this video. Hopefully it does help some of you guys out, whether you're on the MSI Gaming Max motherboard, X470, or the X570 ASUS Tough Gaming. And again, we saw the Gigabyte one before. So hopefully this helps you out. If some of you guys were having issues, so I did make this video for you guys. Again, let me know in the comments, did it help? Do you need something more? Are you still having issues? Again, remember, join the Discord. There's a lot of helpful people in there as well. Thanks for watching, and Rabid out.
Thank you for watching, everyone. If you haven't, please comment, subscribe, and like this video, as well as check out one of these other videos if you have not seen it yet. I do try to stream every Saturday and Sunday, so stay tuned for more future content.